Shunyavadi paschacya de satarine vanchakaupatarupyastya kripa sindhu bhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the fifth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're up to chapter number 19, hearing a description of Jambudvip.
我们学习的是圣典博伽瓦坛第五篇第十九章对张布对普的描述.
All right, so we're hearing about Sukadeva Goswami. Sukadeva Goswami speaking, and he's describing about the glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in particularly in his form as Naranarayan.
我们聆听到的是Sukadeva Goswami 讲述的至尊人格首神以 Naranarayana 他的形体显现的这个荣耀.
And Naranarayan appears in the land of Bharatvarsh. He has his ashram there, a place called Badarik Ashram.
Naranarayana 显现在 Badarik Ashram, 在那个地方是属于 Bharatvarsha 这个地方.
It means in the Himalayas, way up in the Himalayas.
那个地方在喜马拉雅山, Badarik Ashram.
So the Srimad Bhagavatam just tells us how Narada Muni, he has written a book called the Narada Pancharatra. And he's describing about how to cultivate, how to get devotion.
这里描述的Narada Muni, 他写了一本书叫Narada Pancharatra, 那里描述了如何从事奉献服务。
That he says you should do it by cultivating knowledge and practicing the mystic yoga system, then you will get devotion.
他描述到如何通过学习知识以及通过练习神秘瑜伽，然后最后获得奉献.
And Narada Muni taught, he gave this knowledge, he gave it to the Manu, particular Manu, it's called Savarni Manu. And he gave it to Savarni Manu to give to the people.
Narada Muni 把这个知识首先传给了一位祖先，这个祖先叫 Savarni Muni, 然后由 Savarni Muni 然后再传给了后面的人.
He was meant to give it to all the people who live in Bharatvarsha, because the people who live in Bharatvarsha, they follow the principles of Varnashram Dharma.
他想把这个知识传递给巴尔塔巴沙的所有居民，因为在巴尔塔巴沙的这里的居民，他们都遵循瓦纳阿什这个规范原则。
So Narada Muni and all the people who live in Bharatvarsha, they all engage in the service of Naranarayan.
Narada Muni 以及巴尔塔那里的居民，他们都从事对 Naranarayana 的奉献服务。
So, to take a birth in Bharatvarsha is a very great advantage. It's a great opportunity for people in the human form of life to get birth in
Bharatvarsha.
But in order to take advantage of that birth, they must follow the principles of Varnashram Dharma.
但为了很好地利用这一次机会的话，我们那里的人们应该从事 Varnashram Dharma 这个原则.
Means Brahmachari, then Grihastha, then Vanaprastha, and then Sannyas.
这意味着就是社会 被四阶层灵性四阶段，比如说 Brahmachari 然后居士，然后再到这个行脚僧，然后再到 Sannyasi 的这个阶段。
And one should work either as a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya or a Sudra.
然后他们应该在这个Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya 和 Sudra 这些职责里面去工作。
Of course, nowadays, because of Kali Yuga, people are all very fallen, and even in Bharatvarsha, people are very fallen, and they hardly follow Varnashram Dharma.
当然，在现代，由于卡利年代的影响，一切都在失去。即便是Bharatvarsha这里的人们，他们都不是特别严格的遵循这个 Varnashram。
But by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, Krishna consciousness movement has come to give everybody, the whole world, a chance.
但是由于Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的降临，由于他的仁慈，整个世界都得到了这一次机会。
Not just people in India, but people all over the planet.
不仅仅是印度的人们有这个机会了。全体整个世界的人们都有这个机会。
And Krishna consciousness teaches Narada Muni. His path is mainly he's teaching the worship of the deity, and it's called Pancharatriki Vidhi.
Narada Muni 教授了这个人们崇拜神像的这个方法。这个方法被称为 Pancharatrika Vidhi。
So we also do that in Krishna consciousness, but we also follow the other path, which is called Bhagavata Vidhi, which means preaching and studying the scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam and doing propaganda work.
我们在 Krishna 知觉之中也崇拜神像，但是我们还有另外一个方法，这个方法叫 Bhagavata Vidhi， 也就是说我们在这个里面还有其他一部分的工作会做。
Yeah.We have to spread the message of the Bhagavatam.
我们得传播 Bhagavatam 的讯息。
Preach the glories of the Lord.
传播主的荣耀。
Not just sit in the temple and worship the deity.
而不仅仅只是在庙宇里面崇拜神像。
So we combine both. We worship the deity in the temple, and we also go out for preaching.
因此我们把两者结合起来，我们不仅在庙宇里面崇拜神像，我们也到外面去印书派书。
And give the holy name, perform Sankirtan.
把圣名给予别人，从事这个齐颂圣名的运动。
So Narada Muni and the people of Bharatvarsha, they all worship Naranarayan by offering prayer.
Narada Muni 和 Bharatvarsha 那里的居民，他们崇拜 Narayana， 用下面的这个祷文。
And they describe how Naranarayan is very self-controlled, and he is without any false prestige.
他说，这个 描述到 Narayana 是一个非常控制自我的人。
And he's without false ego.
他免于虚假的声望。
And people who have no material possessions, they're very attached to him.
那些没有物质财富，对物质财富不依附的这些人，他们却非常依附这个 Naranarayana。
And he Naranarayan is the guru of all the Paramahamsas.
Naranarayana 是主 Naranarayana 是所有至尊这个阶段 Paramahamsa 这个阶段他们的灵性导师。
Paramahamsa means that the topmost sannyasis, the best of the sannyasis.
Paramahamsa 意味着是最好的最顶尖的那些 sannyasis.
So Naranarayana is the guru for all the self-realizedEven people are self-realized. He's their master. He's their teacher.
所以主 Naranarayana 是这些觉悟自我的人的这些灵性导师。
So Narada Muni chants to Naranarayan. He says that, you know, Narayan is the personality of Godhead.
So Narada Muni chants the Narayana, this, 主的名字，说他是至尊人格首身。
And he's the master of all the material world.
他是所有物质世界的主人。
Foolish people, they think Narayan has a material body.
那些愚蠢的人认为 Narayan 有一个物质的躯体。
But we see Narayan is never affected by hunger or thirst or is never tired.
但是我们知道 Narayan 他从不被饥渴、口渴、疲倦所打扰。
And he can see everything. He sees everything which is taking place.
他可以看到一切。
So he is actually the supreme soul, the Lord of everyone.
因此，他事实上是超灵，是每个人心中的那个超灵。
His body is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
他的身体是永恒、超然极乐和充满了知识。
He creates the material world, but he's not attached to it.
他创造了整个物质世界，但是他一点也不依附它。
If we create something, we become very attached to it.
但是如果我们创造一点点事情，我们会非常的依附。
But Narayan, he's not attached to anything.
但是主哪儿哪儿样呢？他不依附任何事情。
And he's not disturbed by any needs of the body.
他也不被身体的需要所打扰。
We get hungry, we get thirsty, we get tired, but he doesn't.
我们会饥饿，我们会口渴，我们也会感到疲惫，但是他不会。
Actually, everything in this world belongs to him.But we think it's ours.
事实上，所有的一切都是属于他，但是我们却认为这一切是我们自己的。
We are always attached to the things of the material world.
因为我们总是很依附于这个物质世界。
The men are attached to the women, and the women are attached to the men.
一个男人非常依附一个女人，一个女人也依附一个男的。
But Krishna's not like that. He doesn't have these faults.
但是 Krishna 不是这样的，他没有这些缺陷。
He's above all that. He's free from all of the bodily affection.
他超越所有的躯体的影响。
So Narada Muni prays to Narayan that you are the master of all the mystic yoga.
Narada Muni 继续祈祷道，您是所有神秘瑜伽之主。
When the yogis give up the material body at the time of death, when the yogi gives up the body, they keep their mind at the lotus feet of Narayan.
当这个瑜伽师要放弃躯体，就是死亡之际，他们会把他们的心意专注于 Narayana 的莲花足上。
That is the perfection of yoga.
这是瑜伽的完美。
That is real detachment, to just be attached to the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord.
这就是不依附，这是真正的不依附。这他的意思是把你的衣服专注于至尊主上。
So if we seriously practice bhakti yoga during this lifetime, if we practice very seriously and we understand our position in relation to Krishna, then we get liberated from the material world.
如果我们这一生非常严肃的修习奉爱瑜伽，了解我们和至尊主的这个关系的话，我们是可以在从这个物质世界得到解脱的。
Even if we had before we came to Krishna consciousness, if we'd done a lot of sinful things, but if we become attached to the Supreme Lord, then we will get freed of all these sinful reactions.
即便我们在休息以前有很多的罪恶活动，但是如果我们能够一直保持着把心意专注于主的话，我们是可以从这所有的罪恶活动中得到解脱的。
But we have to be able to think of Krishna. We have to think of his form, or his pastimes, or his qualities, or his activities.
但是我们要能够想到 Krishna 的形体。 逍遥时光活动以及它的品质。
So thinking of Krishna's activities and Krishna's qualities, this way then we don't think of anything material.
如果能够一直想着 Krishna的形体、逍遥时光活动和品质的话， 那么我们就不会去想着其他的物质上的一些事情。
So that is actual liberation.
这就是解脱的。
So at the time of death, when we leave the body, we have to really concentrate the mind to think of Krishna.
在我们离开躯体，在我们要死的那一刻，我们应该很用心的把心意专注于Krishna。
Then we can be sure to go back to Godhead.
那毫无疑问，我们就可以回归守身。So
Narada Muni continues. He describes. He says, materialistic people, they're very attached to the body.
Narada Muni 继续描述道，这些物质主义者们总是很依附于他的躯体。They
want a lot of comfort for the body.
他们想要自己的身体总是很舒适。
And they always think about their wife and their children and their money.
他们总是想着他们的妻子、孩子和钱。
And they're very attached to the material body. Although the body is just full of stool and urine, they're very attached to the material body.
即便这个躯体充满了粪便和尿液，但是他们还是这些物质主义者还是非常依附这个躯体。
So if someone's in Krishna consciousness, but if he's also afraid of giving up the body, then he's been wasting his time. He hasn't been following properly.
如果一个人在修习 Krishna 之觉，但是他还是很依附这个躯体的话，那就意味着他并没有休息得很恰当，他只是在浪费时间而已。
So it's very important that we develop this detachment from the body.
因此，修习这种对躯体的不依附是非常重要的。Materialistic
people, they never want to give up the body. They're always trying to live longer.
物质主义者，他们总是很依附这个躯体，不想放弃这个躯体。他们想让在这个躯体里面生活的更长一些。
And we always, and then the materialistic man thinks about his family, and he thinks, if I go, nobody will be there to take care of them.
这些物质主义者在死的时候，他想着，如果我走了，我的妻子、孩子就没有人照顾他们。And
he thinks, if I go, they'll never live without me. They need me. I have to stay to serve them, to take care of them.
他们离不开我。 我想我真想和他们一直在一起，好好的照顾他们。So
we have to, very important to, if we're doing Krishna consciousness or any yoga, we have to get detached from the body relationships.
我们在修习奉爱瑜伽，而且无论是任何瑜伽的时候，我们都应该修习，小心培养这种不依附。
The Vedas say from the age of 50, you have to retire, you have to go to the forest.
伟达的这个原则里面讲，在50岁的时候，你应该退休，去到森林。
Because half the life is over, we have to get ready for death, and it takes half the life to get detached.
因为生命的一半的时间都一半都已经没了，应该用最后一半的这个时间用来培养布衣服。
We have to prepare. It takes time, and that's why people, even great kings, they give up the kingdom and they go and live in the forest to do austerity.
因为培养这个布衣服也是需要时间的。我们可以看到那些，即便是伟大的那些国王，他们也需要放弃他们的，他们也需要退休和放弃去到森林。
Now in the Kali Yuga, we can't go to the forest, but we should take shelter of the Krishna consciousness movement.
在这个卡利年代，在现今的这个情况下，我们不可能去到森林，但是我们得脱避于 Krishna 知觉。
We can come and live in Mayapur or go to Vrindavan, live in Vrindavan, and prepare to leave the body.
我们可以到 Vrindavan 或者 Mayapur。在那里准备离开躯体。
So when we practice bhakti yoga, we should understand that we're preparing for that moment when we're going to leave the body.
我们要理解，我们如果在修习奉爱瑜伽的话，我们是在为那个时刻，为那个要离开躯体的时刻，是在做准备。我们要离开这个躯体。
When we become detached from the body, that is success in our yoga.
如果我们真的能够对身体不依附的话，这是瑜伽的成功。
So, Krishna consciousness, we have to do our duty without attachment.
在 Krishna 知觉中，我们做我们的职责，但是不要有依附。
Right? We do our duties, our whatever devotional duties we have, we do them without material attachment.
我们做我们的奉爱的服务的职责，但是我们不依附。
We have to give up the anxiety about the needs of the body.
我们得放弃这种焦虑，我们放弃这种躯体的依附。
Some people are very concerned for their body. They have to have this. So many things they need for their body comfort to make themselves peaceful.
有些人总是很焦虑，很担心，想着我的身体需要这样的舒适，要那样的舒适，我需要这样才能够平和等等。
But all of these things are very temporary. The body is temporary. We're going to leave it very soon.
但是所有的这一切其实都非常的短暂，因为我们很快的也会离开这个躯体。
So we have to get detached from the material body.
因此我们应该对这个躯体不依附。
So Narada Muni prays to Nara Narayan. He prays to Nara Narayan. He says, please help us, give us the power to do bhakti yoga.
Narada Muni 向主 Nara Narayan 祈祷道，请仁慈的帮助我们，给我们力量，让我们从事奉爱瑜伽。
Then we can control our restless mind, and we can bring our mind to think of you.
这样我们就可以控制我们不安的这种心意，让它专注于您。
We're very attached to the material body, but we know this body is useless.
我们非常依附这个躯体，我们也知道这个躯体实际上是毫无用处的。
We're attached to everything in relation to the body as well, not only our material body, but everything in relation to the body we're also attached to.
我们不仅依附这个躯体，还依附和这个躯体有关的一切东西。我们总是那么的依附。
The family members, the children, and then also the home, the property, the money.
比如说家庭成员，这个家庭，还有这个钱财。
These are all attachments, and they keep us in the material world.
这些都是我们的依附，把我们锁在这个物质世界。
The only way we can give up this attachment is by doing bhakti yoga.
而去除这个依附的唯一方法是从事奉献服务。
So Narada Muni prays to Nara Narayan, Narayan, he said, please help us, please give us the power to do this bhakti yoga.
因此 Narada Muni 向 Narayan 的祈祷，请给我力量，让我来从事奉爱服务。
Somebody was just asking me today, they said, what is Krishna's desire? What does Krishna want us to do?
今天有人发信息问我，到底什么是 Krishna 的愿望？ Krishna 到底想让我们做什么？
So Krishna's desire is there in the Bhagavad Gita. He says what he wants us to do.
Krishna 的愿望在《博伽梵歌》写得很清楚，他写，他告诉了我们，我们应该做什么。
At the end of the ninth chapter, Krishna tells us the most confidential knowledge. He says, Manmana bhava mad bhakto madhyachi mam namaskuru. He said, engage your mind in thinking of me and become my devotee and worship me and offer obeisances to me.
在第九章描述了这个机密的话题，机密的话题。主 Krishna 说道，时常想着我，成为我的奉献者，顶拜我，向我从事奉献服务。
Then in the 18th chapter, at the end of the 18th chapter, Krishna tells Arjuna to surrender to me, give up all religion, just surrender to me.
而在第十八章的最末尾的部分， Krishna 跟 Arjuna 说，放弃所有的职责，向我臣服。
So Krishna is telling us his desire, what he wants us to do.
So Krishna 告诉了我们他的愿望，他希望我们做什么。
So we have to follow. We should try to please Krishna, try to satisfy his desire.
因此，我们应该遵循这些，我们应该试着去满足 Krishna 的这些愿望。
If we don't try to follow Krishna's desire, then we follow our own desires, and our desires are just for sense gratification.
如果我们不满足 Krishna 的愿望，我们就会想着要满足自己的愿望，而我们自己的愿望都是感官享乐。
We have to give up the body attachment.
我们得放弃躯体的依附。
And we have to become attached to Krishna.
我们得把这种依附转为去依附 Krishna.
Right, you don't have to give up your family, but you have to see them in relation to Krishna.
我们不是说要放弃我们的家庭，我们应该在他们身上看到他们和 Krishna 的关系。
So if we just change the attachment to Krishna, then you can follow the path, you can get liberation easily.
如果我们把这种依附转为对 Krishna 的依附，我们就能超越，我们就能很容易的回归。
Nature of everyone to be attached. So the best thing to be attached to is Krishna.
人的本性就是会依附，所以最好的依附是依附 Krishna.
Krishna will never leave us. Krishna will never get old. Krishna will never.He's always our best friend.
Krishna 不会依附，不会离开我们。Krishna 也永远是我们的朋友。Krishna 也不会变老。
And Krishna's Bhagavan, he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He has everything.
Krishna 是 Bhagavan, 他是至尊人格守神本人，他拥有的一切。
He's not going to cheat us, he's not going to exploit us, he's not going to take advantage of us.
Krishna 不会利用我们，他也不会欺骗我们。
Krishna is always thinking how to bring us back home, back to Godhead.
Krishna 总是会想着如何把我们带回家园，回归守神。
And for that purpose, that's why he comes here, and that's why he sends his pure devotees here.
为了这个目的，他总是，这就是他为什么总是会来到这里，然后派遣他的那些纯粹奉献者来到这里。
He wants to bring us all back to the lotus feet of Krishna.
他想把我们所有的人都带回到 Krishna 的莲花足下。
So Narada Muni is describing about Bharat Vash, And he describes many mountains and many rivers there.
Narada Muni 继续描述的 Bhartavarsha 这片地方，那里有很多的山川河流。
There are many mountains, there are also smaller hills, and there's rivers, large and small rivers.
那里有许多大大小小的山川，大大小小的河流。
Big mountains like Govardhan and Chitrakoot.
比如说大的这个山 Govardhan 和 Chitrakoot.
Venkata.Vindhya, the Vindhya hills.
Vindhya.
These are all well known in the scriptures. Many great personalities live there.
在那里有很多伟大的人物都住在那些地方。
And among the rivers, there are two main rivers.
在这些河流之中有两条主要的河流。
The main rivers are Brahmaputra and the Shona.
其中，他们名字是 Brahmaputra 和 Shona.
But there are many other rivers like the Kaveri and the Godavari. You've all heard of these.
还有其他的一些河流，比如说 Kaveri 和 Godavari.
Narmada.
Narmada,
Saraswati, Gomati,
Saraswati, Gomati,
Sarayu, right? We saw Sarayu when we went to Ayodhya. When we went to Ayodhya, that's the place of beside Lord Rama.
我们去这个 Ayodhya, 在主拉玛住的那个地方旁边就有一条 Sarayu.
So the people of Bharatvarsha, they are always purified, they keep themselves purified because they always remember these rivers.
Bharatvarsha 地的这些居民总是很净化，因为他们很常想着这些河。
And sometimes they chant the names of the rivers like a mantra.
有些时候他们唱诵把这些河流的名字当作曼陀罗一样去唱诵。
Sometimes they will go to the river and touch them and take bath there.
有些时候他们去到河流边，然后去触碰这个河流，在河流里面沐浴。
So all the inhabitants of Bharatvarsha they keep themselves pure in this way.
所以巴尔塔瓦沙的这些居民通过这种方式，总是让他们很净化。
So because these rivers are all transcendental, if we just remember them, or touch them, or bathe in them, we get a lot of spiritual benefit.
因为这些河流全部都是超然的，只是靠记忆它们、触碰它们，或在河流里面沐浴，就能得到很多的灵性益处。
Right? We have the mantra, we know the mantra.Ganga cha Yamunaye Chaiva Godavari Sarasatim Narmada Sindhu Kaveri Jalismin Sanadam Kuru. That's a well-known mantra with the names of different holy rivers.
刚刚这个曼陀罗是一个非常有名的曼陀罗，里面包含了很多有名的河流。
So sometimes when we do Akshman,We want to do Akshman, we will call all the holy rivers to come present in the Akshman pot.
有些时候我们做这个净化仪式，我们会念诵这个曼陀罗，把所有的河流引到这里来。
Sometimes we want to bathe the deity, so we want the holy rivers, we want them all to come, and we can call them by mantra.
有些时候我们要给神像做沐浴的时候，我们也念诵这个曼陀罗，把所有的河流呼唤他们，请来到这里。
So holy rivers are very, very important for the planet.
因此，圣河对这个地球是对这个星球是非常非常重要的。
And great yogis and sages they like to go and live on the bank of the river.
那些瑜伽师那些圣人们总是喜欢住在河的旁边恒河岸边。
Prabhupada taught us, there's a saying by Chanakya Pandit. Chanakya Pandit, the famous moralist of India, he said, don't go to that place where there is no temple, where you have no friend, and where there's no river.
Chanakya Pandit, India的一个道德很高准的这个模范，他说到了。 不要去到一个那里没有河流、没有庙宇、没有朋友的地方。
If there's no river there, then you have no place to go and bathe. That's a big problem.
如果那里没有河流的话，你没有地方去沐浴，这是一个很大的问题。
So very important. You go where that you go to a place where there's a river.
因此去到一个有河流的地方是很重要的。So,
people who take birth in Bharatvarsha, they're divided in the different qualities, the mode of goodness, passion, or ignorance.
在巴拉特瓦沙的这片土地出生的人，他们根据善良、激情和愚昧属性划分。
So some of the people in Bharatvarsha are very exalted, great personalities, very pure.
有一些人在巴拉特瓦沙这片土地上，他们非常的崇高，非常的纯粹。
And some are very ordinary people.
也有一些很普通的人。
But you've got some people, they're very terrible, they're really disgusting. They're the mode of ignorance.
也有一些非常处于愚昧形态、非常卑劣的人。
So everybody who takes birth in Bharatvarsha, they take birth according to their past karma.
每一个出生在巴拉特瓦沙这个地方的人，他们出生是根据他们过去的业报所决定。
So if somebody is fortunate, they will take shelter of a spiritual master, and he will train them in the service of Lord Vishnu.
如果一个人非常幸运的话，他会得到一位灵性导师，在灵性导师的训练下，他去崇拜主Vishnu。
And he will train them according to the different duties of the Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sudra.
他会被训练根据按照社会四阶层 Brahma, Vaishya 和
And he will recognize the particular nature of that person, either to be brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, or sannyas. So, Lord Vishnu, there's a statement in the scriptures that said, Lord Vishnu is worshipped when we follow the Varnashram.
So this is the
way in which we can satisfy the Supreme Lord.
这是崇拜，这个是取悦主的一个方法。When
Ramananda Roy met Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya asked Ramananda Roy to give a verse from the scripture about the goal of life.
当 Ramananda Roy 见到主 Chaitanya 的时候，主 Chaitanya 希望他给出一个诗节来描述生命的最高目标。So
Ramananda Roy quoted a verse from the Padma Purana, which says, the goal of life is to follow Varnashram Dharma.
Ramananda Roy 从 Padma Purana 那里引述一个诗节，人生命的最高目标是从事 Varnashram.
Varnashram Achara Pada Purushena Parapuman Vishnu Rajati, like that. I don't remember all the Sanskrit, but the verse is stating that we can satisfy the Lord by doing the duties of Varna and Ashram.
在这个诗节之中描述到，主维士努是通过在 Varna Ashram 的体制中被崇拜、被取悦的。
So that is the bottom line, that Lord Chaitanya heard it, he said, yeah, that's okay, but he said, there's a lot more, there's much higher than this, you can go higher.
主 Chaitanya 说, 这个也是正确的,但是还是有更高的。
People follow Varnashram Dharma, it's material, it's not necessarily spiritual. They just do their duties, they work in a particular position. It's material life.
人们从事 Varnashram 这个职责实际上是物质的，并没有什么灵性的。人们只是在从事他们的职责，做他们应该做的事情而已。
Even once a brahmachari or a sannyasi, it can be very material. They're just doing material duties. They have no devotion for the Supreme Lord.
即便他是一个 brahmachari 或者说是一个 sannyasi, 他也有可能是一个很物质的人。他根本没和至尊主有什么关联。
So Lord Chaitanya rejected this because Lord Chaitanya wants to preach about devotional service.
因此主柴坦尼亚拒绝了这一个。主柴坦尼亚希望人们从事奉献服务。
So people perform these duties, but it doesn't mean they make spiritual advancement.
因此人们虽然从事这些职责，但并不意味着他们是灵性上很进步的人。
But it's a good way to organize the society.
但这个方法是组织整个社会的一个很好的方法。
And it's Krishna's own system by which to organize society.
这也是 Krishna 自己的方式来组建这个社会，是 Krishna 的方式。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita,Krishna said, Chaturvarnam mayashristam guna karma vibhagasha. Chaturvarnam mayashristam. He said, I created the four divisions of the Varnas. I created them according to guna and karma, according to quality and work.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，我根据人们的 guna， 我根据人们的品质和活动来，还有他们的品质和活动来划分的这个社会四阶层。
Yeah, nothing to do with birth. It's according to how you work and the qualities you have.
而这个社会四阶层和临近四阶段，它和这个人的出身没有关系，它是根据人的活动和品质决定的。
But of course, our qualities which we have will depend, it's also influenced by our birth.
当然我们的品质也会被我们的出身所影响。
So, Prabhupada says, you know, at the present time, there's a lot of demons, they don't want to follow this Varnashram system.
圣帕帕德在这里描述到有一些恶魔，他们无视这个 Varna Ashram 的制度。
And there's nowhere, nobody trains people in Brahmachari life or how to be a good Grihastha or a Vanaprastha or Sannyasi. You don't get training for that very easily.
也没有人去教导人们如何去成为一个好的 Brahmana, 一个好的 Chatriya, 一个 Vaishya 或者 Shudra, 或者说 Brahmachari Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasi.没有人去教导这个，他们很难去学到如何成为这些社会、这些阶层或者说这些阶段。
The modern governments, they don't, they're all against teaching religion.
现在的这个管理部门、政府部门，他们非常反对宗教。
Both in the East and in the West, they don't want religion.
不管是东方还是西方的这个人，他们都非常反对宗教。
So because there's no proper training education, people become very sinful, very degraded.
因此没有恰当的教育，人们越来越堕落，越来越罪恶。
So in this way, they become animals in their next life.
朝着这样的方式，他们就会 在下一生成为一个动物。
But Krishna consciousness is saving, can save people from that, can teach them the real duty of human life.
但是 Krishna 知觉就可以拯救这些人们，能够拯救人体的生命。
Save people from going to hell.
能够拯救人们下地狱。
So Narada Muni says, after many births, when our pious activity, we will get the results of our pious activities, we may get the opportunity to associate with pure devotees.
Narada Muni 说道，经历过许许多多的诞生之后，一个虔诚的人的活动成熟之时，他会得到与纯粹奉献者联谊的机会。
And if we get association with the pure devotee, it can show us how to get free from the ignorance.
如果能够和一个纯粹奉献者联谊，他能够向我们展示如何从愚昧之中解脱出来。
We get very attached to karma, to enjoying the results of our work, and that's our ignorance.
我们非常依附于我们的工作，我们的结果，这是我们的愚昧。
But if we associate with devotees, then we can learn how to do service for Krishna.
如果我们和一个奉献者联谊的，一个纯粹奉献者联谊的话，我们会学到如何向主 Krishna 做奉爱服务。
And Krishna is not attached to the material world. He's beyond the material world.
Krishna 是不依附这个物质世界的，他是超越这个物质世界的。
So that doing service for Krishna, that is bhakti yoga, and that is the real path of liberation.
而向 Krishna 做奉爱服务，这个属于奉爱瑜伽，这是真正的解脱。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes about liberation. He says, Brahma Bhuta Prasanatma.He said, one who knows Brahman, he will be a joyful soul. And stop. Go ahead.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主 Krishna 描述了这个处在超然境界的人，他觉悟到至尊 Brahman.
So he becomes a joyful soul.
他变得非常全然的喜乐。
And...He never hankers or laments for anything. Na sochati, na kanchati. He does not want anything and he does not lament. He's not sorry about losing anything. And he sees all living entities equally. Sama sarveshu bhuteshu. He sees everything, all life equal.
他对待每一生物都一视同仁。
Magbhaktim parame param. That in that stage, then he's ready to take up devotional service.
在这种状态下，他达到为我做纯粹奉献服务的境界。
So just understanding the Brahman, that is the beginning of liberation.
因此，只是达到 Brahman 的这个境界，他只是开。这个解脱境界，它的
and
is the beginning of the
liberation.
它只是解脱的开始。
And Paramatma is a bit more advanced than Brahman.
而觉悟到超灵，这个比Brahman的这境界更要高一些。
But above both Brahman and Paramatma, one can go on to realize the Supreme Lord.
而在这个 Brahman Paramatma 更高，比这个前面两个更高的是对至尊人格守神本人的觉悟。
And one should realize that we are the servant of that Supreme Lord.
一个人应该觉悟到他是至尊人格守至尊主本人的仆人。
So people in the material world, they're all moving in the wrong way, in the wrong direction.
在这个物质世界的这些人们，他们总是朝着错误的方向在行动。
They work to become attached to the body instead of getting free from the body.
他们在这个物质世界总是很依附这个躯体，而事实上他们应该从这个依附之中解脱出来。
But if we understand we're Brahman, then we're not attached to the body. We know the body's useless.
如果一个人能觉悟到 Brahman 的话，他知道这个躯体是无用的，我们不应该依附这个躯体。
So then we become, then we, when we know the body is not important, then we think about the soul, how to develop, cultivate the soul.
如果我们能够觉悟到这个躯体是无用的，那么我们才能够转向想着这个灵魂。
So that is actual liberation when we begin to do devotional service.
那个时候才是解脱，我们开始从事奉献服务。
So devotee has to be, we have to become attached. We should be attracted to the form of Krishna.
人应该被 Krishna 的这个形体依附，受到 Krishna 形体的吸引。
Just like the young man is attracted to the beautiful young woman.
就像一个男人被一个年轻的漂亮的女子所吸引。
So the same way devotee is attracted to the beauty of Krishna.
同样的方式，奉献者应该被 Krishna 的美丽所吸引。
So he forgets all about materialistic life.
这样他就会对物质的这个生活就会忘记物质世界的这各种生活。
He doesn't think about trying to satisfy his senses anymore.
他也不会想着要去满足他的物质感官的。
He's engaged in spiritual activities.
他开始从事对灵性活动的服务。
And he gets his happiness from the spiritual activities.
在灵性的活动中，他得到快乐。
So Narada Muni is telling the human form of life is very special for self-realization.
Narada Muni 描述到，一个人体生命对觉悟自我来说是很重要的。
And all the demigods in heaven, they know this as well, and they speak about this. They say the people on Bharat Varsh are so fortunate.
所有处在天堂星宿的这些人们也知道这个道理，所以他们说到，能够出生在巴尔塔巴舍之地的这些人们是非常的幸运。
The demigods say to be born, to be there in a human body in Bharat Varsh, they must have done a lot of pious activities.
这些半神们说到，能够在巴尔塔巴舍之地以人体生命投生的这些人们。前身一定做了很多的虔诚活动。
Or the Supreme Lord must be very pleased with them.
或者说是至尊人格守神一定对他非常的满意。
Because how else could they be so fortunate to get the human body and Bharat Varsh and to do devotional service?
他们是怎么能够如此幸运能够在巴尔塔巴舍之地以人形投身从事奉献服务。
The demigods say, we want to take our birth there to do devotional service, but these people, they're already doing it.
这些半神们说，我们非常想投身在这个地方从事奉献服务，但是这些人却已经在那里从事奉献服务了。
So there's a nice verse which is spoken by Lord Chaitanya, which Prabhupada often quoted,which says, one who takes his birth as a human being in Bharat Varsh, India, then he should make his life successful.
圣帕帕德经常引述主柴坦尼亚描述了一句话，就是在柴坦尼亚查尔塔米瑞塔中引述了一句话，在印度巴尔塔瓦舍之地出生的人类应当使人体生命得到成功。
He should make his own life successful, and then he should work for the benefit of other people to help them to make their life successful.
他不仅应该让自己的人生获得成功，他应该帮助其他的人，为其他的人人生成功而工作。
Because in India, Bharat Varsh, there's many opportunities to do devotional service.
在 Bhartavarsha 在印度有很多从事奉爱服务的机会。
Lord Chaitanya personally came there to teach us how to progress, how to practice spiritual life.
主 Chaitanya 亲自显现在那里，教导人们如何从事奉献服务。
And in this place, Bharatvarsa, one can easily understand Bhakti Yoga, and one can easily practice it.
在那里，人们可以非常很容易的明白奉爱服务，也可以很容易的修习。
So we practice devotional service, and then we preach it to other people all over the world.
因此我们修习奉爱服务，同时还把这个奉爱服务 传遍整个世界。
And this way, all of these people, all the people all over the world can benefit.
这样整个世界的人们都会受益。
So this way, Narada Muni is glorifying the land of Bharatvarsha.
用这样的方式， Narada Muni 荣耀了 Bharatvarsha 之地的这个地方。
Okay, are there any questions?
Okay, let me see. 我们讲到这儿看有没有问题。Not yet.
我们继续。
好。有一个问题 Gurudev.
Oh, really? 真的吗？
是吗？ Yeah, from Usha Mataji.
Usha?
Yeah.
Oh.
顶拜 Gurudev, 翻译和 YY 服务的奉献者们莲花组，感谢 Guru 实力 Guru 故事讲课，精准扶贫，每次听到不依附这个课题都很扎心。请问第一个问题，不依附在世俗上奉献者的行为表现，不依附在世俗事物上奉献者的行为表现是什么？二，服务神像时很依附穿亮丽的衣服首饰，好品质的菩萨的摆设神坛，总错过耽误了时间，算不算依附？谢谢 Guru。She has two questions. So thanks Gurudev, basis to Gurudev. I want to ask the when I listen the detachment, detachment, I have a lot of feeling. I want to ask, if the devotee undetached, not detached to the material world, what is his performance?What he looks like when he detached to the material things.
What does he look like when he's detached from the material?
Yeah, behavior.
What's his behavior?
Yes.
Well, he's detached from the material. He has to be attached to the spiritual.
不依附于物质的表现是他很依附于灵性。
So he should be attached to Krishna.
他应该很依附于 Krishna.
In other words, he will chant the holy name a lot, and he will read the books about Krishna, and he will worship Krishna.
换句话说，他会唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名，会阅读他的书籍，会崇拜 Krishna.
No, he will use his time all the day.Practically in the service of Krishna.
他会很好地花他的时间，一整天的时间去服务 Krishna.
He'll always be thinking about Krishna. Where is Krishna?
他总会想着 Krishna. Krishna 在什么地方呀？
Just like Lord Chaitanya was living in Jagannath Puri. And so he was always having Krishna consciousness.Sometimes he's doing chanting, they're doing kirtan, sankirtan with all the people. And other times he's hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam.
当主 Chaitanya 在加格纳普瑞的时候，他也总是想着 Krishna， 他唱诵，而且做 Sankirtan， 还有一些奉献者，他们在聆听圣殿博加瓦坛。
So, Lord Chaitanya's day and night, it was only Krishna Katha, topics of Krishna, and discussions about Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 的整日整夜都是 Krishna 的话题，都是想，都是谈论着 Krishna.
And he would relish hearing all the songs about Krishna.
他们总是在聆听和唱诵 Krishna 的歌曲。
He would hear about Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj. He would hear again and again.
他会一次又一次地聆听 Dhruva Maharaj 和 Prahlad Maharaj 的故事。
And he would go to see Lord Jagannath in the temple. He would see the deity.
他也会到加格纳的庙里去见主加格纳的神像。
And then he would organize all the people to have big kirtan.
他还会组织普通的人们来举行一场盛大的 kirtan 唱诵。
Chanting of the holy names.
唱诵主的圣名。
To give everyone spiritual benefit. He would think about how to benefit them, the best way to benefit them, sankirtan, the holy name.
他总是想着普通如何能够让普通大众受益，而让普通大众受益的最好的方法是 Sankirtan， 给予人们圣名的方式。
So if you read the Bhagavad Gita, the Bhagavad Gita in the second chapter, you know, towards the end of the second chapter, Arjuna asks a question to Krishna.
如果你读《薄伽梵歌》第二章的最末尾的时候，阿尔朱纳问的。两个问题给 Krishna。
No， 没有说两个问题，一个问题。
Okay.
He said,
问了一个问题给 Krishna。
He said that what is the nature of one who has achieved transcendence？
那里描阿尔朱纳问到一个处在超然境界中的人，他们的表现是怎样的
？Right. He wants to know how does he speak。And what is his language?
他说什么？他的语言行为是什么
？And how does he sit? And how does he walk?
他是如何坐，如何行走的
？So Arjuna wanted to know about, you know, how to recognize someone who is really transcendental.
Arjuna 想识别一个处在超然之境界之中的人。他是如何去识别这样的一个人
？So Krishna describes, you know, how what he would do when he's not using his senses, and what he would do when he is using his senses.
所以 Krishna 描述了当他不用感官的时候是什么，当他运用自己的感官的时候是什么样的行为
？Krishna describes the behavior of somebody in transcendental consciousness.
Krishna 描述了处在超然境界之中的人的行为。
They have no material desire.
他们没有物质的愿望。
They don't worry about the body at all.
他们并不担心这个物质躯体。
Of course, they have to take care of the body. They have to wash it, clean it.
当然，人们应该照顾这个躯体，他应该。清洁，保持他的洁净。
Lord Chaitanya, when he was living at Puri, he would go to take bath in the sea, and he would go three times a day.
主 Chaitanya 在 Puri, 加格纳的 Puri 住的时候，他每天去到海边，他在海边里，在他海里面沐浴，而且每天是去三次。
Because he's a sannyasi, he's a very strict sannyasi. A strict sannyasi, they'll take bath three times a day.
因为他是一个萨尼亚西，而且是一个很严格的萨尼亚西。萨尼亚西一天应该沐浴三次。
So in the Lord Chaitanya, he would, that meant he would go to the sea, go to the beach, on the beach there, he'd take his bath there.
所以主 Chaitanya 在海边那里 他在那里每天沐浴三次。
Of course, at the beach, you have to, I mean, salt water. You take bath in salt water. It's not very easy because, you know, you want to take bath again after you bathe in the sea to get the salt off your body.
因为在海边那个海水是很咸的。如果你在海边沐浴的话，你还得再沐浴一次，因为这个还得再沐浴一次，把这个盐，把身上这个盐给去掉。
So you're asking, you know, about somebody who is transcended. You want to understand somebody who is not in bodily consciousness. You know, they have to take care of the body, but at the same time, they're not attached to the body.
你想了解一个不依附的人，他一个处在超人境界人境界之中的人。他们一方面是不依附这个，他们一方面是照顾这个躯体，好好的照顾这个躯体。另外一个方面，他并不依附这个躯体。
And just like someone is a grihastha, they can also be transcendentally situated, but they take care of their family. They do not neglect the family.
就像一个处在 grihastha 中的人，居士生活中的人，他也可以变得很超然，他。在居士生活之中，但他不忽视家庭的这个家人，他也不忽视家庭的责任。
We have to take care. We have to do our duties. We have to be responsible.
我们得做我们的责任，我们得有责任，承担责任。
But at the same time, we have to cultivate attachment to Krishna.
但是同时，我们也得培养对 Krishna 的依附。
So Prabhupada was in America, and he had to go to the immigration office, and the lady in the immigration office was interviewing Prabhupada and asking him about what he was teaching.
圣帕帕德在美国的时候，他有一次去那个移民局，移民局的那个人，那个女士就采访了他，有采访了他。
So the, you know, Prabhupada was saying about how you have to be Krishna conscious, but at the same time you have to do your duties, do your work, do your jobs.
圣帕帕德跟那个女士说，你应该有 Krishna 知觉，同时呢，你应该从事你的工作，你有你的职责，你有你的工作。
So the lady said, oh, it must be quite difficult to do both things, to balance both.
然后那位女士说，如果要做这两个方面的事情，一定会非常的困难。
But Prabhupada said to her, he said, no, he said, just like you, said you're a young woman, and he said, you're working here in the office, you have your job as an immigration officer, but at the same time, you keep yourself looking very nice, your hair is very nice, you're very neat and clean, you're tidy.
圣帕帕德说，这个其实并不难，就像你在这里，你是一位办公室的这个工作人员，但是呢，你在这里工作，但是呢，你也保持你自己非常漂亮，非常整洁，非常好的这个状态。
So like that, this is, you know, you do both things, you know, you keep yourself looking nice, and at the same time you do your job.
你又让你自己看起来很漂亮很好，也同时你也履行你的职责。
So devotee, he lives in the material world, and he looks like an ordinary person, but internally he's attached to Krishna.
奉献者在这个物质世界，表面上他住在这个物质躯体里面，他得去工作等等，但是内在的。
And he's always thinking of Krishna.
而且他总是想着 Krishna.
And at any moment he knows he may have to leave the body, he may have to leave the world. He just wants to take shelter of Krishna.
而且在任何一个时刻，他都有可能离开这个躯体，离开这个世界，他得脱避于 Krishna.
We can see the situation in the world today.How dangerous it is.
我们可以看到当今世界的这个情况非常的危险。
With the COVID, disease everywhere. People are dying very easily.
由于这个新冠病毒在全世界的传播，人们很容易就死去了。
So we have to be ready that any moment we may have to leave the body. We have to just simply hold on to Krishna.
我们可能在任何一个片刻就会离开躯体，因此我们应该抓住 Krishna。
But at the same time, we're here in the world. We have to maintain the body. We have to, you know, keep healthy. We have to keep everything neat and clean.
但是我们又在这个物质世界的生活，我们得保持一切清洁整洁。
We cannot just sit back and say, "Okay, I'm waiting for death to come."
我们不能就在那里坐着，哦，我在这里等死。
We have to live, and at the same time, be ready.
我们一方面在这个物质世界里生存着，另外一个方面也要做好回去的准备。
Any other question there?
She asked two questions. The other part is, when we're serving the deities, we are attached to make the deities dressing very nicely and a good prasadam. And when we worship the deities and we worry about the times, missing the times, so are these things is attachment?
Yeah, this is devotional service. We should be attached to devotional service.
这些都是属于奉献服务，我们应该依附奉献服务。
Yeah, we want to serve Krishna favorably, and that means we should be on time.
我们应该服务神像favorably, 应该让就是以神像以神满意的方式，这意味着应该准时。
Krishna likes to eat on time. He's expecting his food to be there on time. And if we're late, it's not good.
Krishna 希望他吃东西的时候是准时吃的。如果我们不准时的供奉的话，这不太好。
Two important principles in deity worship are cleanliness and punctuality.
在服务神像中有两个很重要的原则，第一个是清洁，第二个是准时。
Yeah. If we're not clean and if we're not punctual, then Krishna will leave. Krishna will not be present.
如果我们不清洁，我们也不准时的话， Krishna 不会在那里， Krishna 会离开的。
So we can attract Krishna by the mood of devotion, and we show the devotion by our eagerness to be clean and to be punctual.
Krishna 会被我们的奉爱所吸引，而我们展示奉爱的方法也是我们展示奉爱的方法是通过洁净准时。
When devotees would cook for Prabhupada, if they would be late with his prasadam, Prabhupada could get quite upset with them for coming late.
是有如果奉献者给帕布帕做食物的做普沙的呢？如果这个奉献者给帕布帕做普沙的时候晚了的话，是帕布帕的会非常的不高兴。
Yeah, it's an important thing for health that we should be regulated. We should be regular in our eating habits. You know, eat at the same time.It's better for our health.
我们如果想保持一个好的健康的话，那么每天按时准时的吃饭是一个很好的习惯，对健康很好。
So, yes, we should be attached to serving Krishna. It's nice. It's not a material activity. It's a spiritual activity.
是的，我们应该很好的去服务 Krishna， 这不是一种依附，这是一种灵性的活动。
So we dress the deities. You cannot spend the whole day. Some people, they could spend the whole day just dressing the deity. That's No, it should be done at proper time so that the deity greeting can take place.
当然我们给神像打扮是很好的，但是不要花去一整天的时间给神像打扮，我们应该用恰当的时间打扮，然后再去迎接神像。
And then cooking, if you cook, you cook all day, and you say, oh, I didn't get it right, I'll cook again, and the devotee's waiting and waiting, he'll lose his appetite. He has to wait so long, he could lose his appetite.
有些人也很喜欢做饭，他觉得这个也没有做好，那个没，他会做一整天，但是呢，奉献者就在等啊等啊，最后等的胃口都失去了。
So, Krishna is a person, and we want to serve him and the best as best we can.
Krishna 是一个人，我们应该用尽我们最好的去服务他。
So he expects to eat on time.
他也希望，他希望能够准时的吃饭。
Okay. 还有别的问题吗
？Yes. From Gita Govinda Mataji, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 翻译和所有的奉献者们，请问我们通过现在的修习程序，内在也是先觉悟 Brahman Paramatma, 然后再觉悟 Krishna 吗？感恩 Guru。Obeisance to Guru Maharaj, I want to know, from our process, are we also, should realize the Brahman first and then Paramatma and then Krishna? From, yes.
No, not required. We can directly go to realize Krishna.
不是这样的，我们可以直接的去觉悟 Krishna。
Yeah, we don't spend time just first to realize the Brahman. But what we do do, we do need to understand that we're not the body.
We don't need to understand that
we're not the body, that we're spirit souls, and then only we can go on to understand about Krishna.
我们得了解我们不是这个躯体，我们是这个灵性的灵魂，因为从这个层面我们才能够理解 Krishna。
So we may understand very very simple knowledge about Brahman and Paramatma。
因此我们是了解这个 Brahman 和 Paramatma 的，我们了解一些他们简单的一些基础的知识。
Like, you know, we can explainThat Brahman is energy, the light, and it's impersonal.
通常我们解释 Brahman 是 Krishna 的一个能量，像一是光。
And Krishna is the super soul in the heart of everyone. He's everywhere in every atom.
Krishna 以超灵住在每一个众生的心中，他无所不在。
He's a witness to everything.
他见证着一切。
But above all that, there's Bhagavan, the person.
在这之上是巴格万，是至尊主，是人。
So, we don't need to, it's not that we have to actually realize the Brahman or the Paramatma, but we can explain.Very basic knowledge about these things.
我们不一定要先觉悟 Brahman 或者 Paramatma, 但是我们要了解他们的这些基础的知识。
We just speak about Krishna. We tell people about Krishna, that Krishna's God, Krishna's the Supreme. We don't need to mention even Brahman and Paramatma, really.
我们谈论的是 Krishna, 谈论的是 Krishna, 至尊人格首身 Krishna, 谈论的他的活动。我们事实上都很少去谈论 Krishna 的这个 Brahman 的这个能量等等。
People just hear about Krishna, they can become attached to Krishna, and they, and they chant Krishna's name and they see the Krishna deity in the temple, okay, then they become Krishna conscious.
我们只是给人们讲述 Krishna， 这样人们就会依附 Krishna， 了解 Krishna， 然后他们就会变得有 Krishna 知觉。
Later on, we can always mention that there is such things as Brahman and Paramatma.
再过之后，人们我们可以向人们解释哦，还有 Brahman， 还有 Paramatma。
If somebody is a Mayavadi, somebody is really in the impersonal.Then we can explain about the Brahman and how it's the energy of Krishna.
如果一个人是 Mayavadi, 他是一个非人格主义者，这样我们可以讲 Brahman, Paramatman, 他实际上都是属于 Krishna.
But for most people, they don't know anything. They don't know anything, so you don't need to tell them about Brahman and Paramatma.
但是对大多数的人来说，他们实际上什么都不知道。我们不必要一开始就给他们讲这个 Brahman Paramatma。
So we just tell them about Krishna。
我们只是告诉他们 Krishna。
Get them attached to Krishna。
让他们变得依附 Krishna。
And everything else will follow in course of time。
一切都会随着这个时间会到来。
But Prabhupada gives the example.If somebody lives up on the 20th floor, we take the lift up. We don't walk up the stairs.
圣帕帕的经常举这个例子，如果一个人住在20层楼的话，人们都是坐电梯上去，不会想着走楼梯。
Because if you walk up the stairs, you may meet someone on the stairs when you're coming up. You meet people and you talk to them, you may never get up to the 20th floor.
因为当你走楼梯的时候，你有可能还会在中途遇到一些人，你遇到他们，然后跟他们聊着聊着，有可能就不会想着再上去了。
And so in the same way, if you introduce people to Brahman, they'll get stuck on Brahman. They may never go past that.
同样的道理，如果你给别人一开始就讲 Brahman 的话，或者别人就对 Brahman 一直感兴趣，就不会想着我再往上走。
They'll think, oh no, I just like it here, I don't want to go any further, I'll just stay in the Brahman.
Oh, 这些人就会说，哦不，我就待在 Brahman, 我不想再往前走。
So, better we just take people straight to Bhagavan, straight to Krishna.
最好的形式就是我们直接把人带到 Bhagavan, 带到 Krishna 那里去。
Let everybody become Krishna conscious.
让每一个人具有Krishna 知觉。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Next question?
Yes.
Next question from Bindu Madhava Prabhu. Dimbai Guru Dev, 感谢翻译和组织者。请问 Guru, 当一位处于居士层眉的奉献者，有居士层面的奉献者有物质欲望的时候，比如说想要换一辆大车，想要个大房子，这时是控制自己的欲望，认为满足这种欲望就是堕落，还是最好目前适当的满足自己的目前最好适当满足自己的欲望更符合当下的状态。 A basis to Gurudev, I want to ask, when a devotee, a grihastha devotee, when he have the material desire, like for example, he want to change an other car, or change a big car, or change a bigger house,At this time, should he control this desire, or he need to think this desire is the fallen? He should satisfy his car and the house, just satisfy a little, and be steady in this situation.
Well, he has to consider.If the bigger car or the bigger house is really necessary for Krishna consciousness.
那么这个奉献者就应该恰当的考虑，他要换一个大的车，一个大的房子，是否对 Krishna 知觉有必要。
For example, maybe you're going to use the car to take other people, you fill it with devotees and take them to programs.
比如说，你需要一个车， 带着这些用这个车带着奉献者去参加一些节目。
Or maybe the bigger house will accommodate more devotees and more people can come for the programs or do yoga together, so you can make a good use of it.
或者说你的大房子能够让更多的奉献者能够在一起，或者说从事瑜伽等等，能够充分的利用这个大房子，你可以。
But if you just get the bigger car or the bigger house to look good, that you want to impress people, it's not very good.
但是如果你想要一个大车，只是为了让人们留下一个好印象，为了让你看上去很好，这个不好。
So you've got to be able to use everything in Krishna's service.
应该让所有的这有能力让这些东西从事于对 Krishna 的奉爱服务之中才行。
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Mathur Nila. 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru 怎么样把家庭成员很好的和 Krishna 连接 ？Obeisance to Guru and devotees. I want to ask Guru Maharaj how to combine the family members' contact to Krishna better.
Well, ideally, the family members, they should perform kirtan together. They should have aarti. They do aarti together, and one person will chant, one person does the aarti, and other people, they will chant and do kirtan. And they should do that every day.
理想的情况下是，这个家庭成员在一起应该唱诵，应该做aarti，比如说一个人在从事 RT， 另外一个人唱诵，大家一起唱，而且是每一天。
They should be able to sing the songs like the Guru Vastikam and the Guru RT.
他们应该能够唱诵这个八颂林诗以及 Guru RT 往 RT 的这个祷文。
Sometimes we get people, they don't know even how to sing the songs which we sing every day.
有些时候我们发现有一些人他们甚至不知道唱诵我们这每天必须要唱的这些歌曲。
So, when I was in Vrindavan, when I was walking around Vrindavan, I could hear from inside the houses, almost every house, they're having kirtan.I could hear the madanga, the kartals. It's so common. So here in Mayapur, it should also be the same. The householders, if you're not there in the temple, then you should do kirtan at home.
当我还在文达文的时候，我当时在街上散步，我可以很清楚地听到，几乎每一个家里面都有米当嘎的声音。他们都有在唱诵，但是在玛雅普，我们也应该这样。我们那些没有去庙里的这个居士，如果没有去庙里的话，我们应该在家里面唱诵。
So it's a very important part of family life that the family come together to do arti and worship the deity.
这是家庭生活中的一个很重要的部分，家庭成员一起。崇拜神像。
Yeah, and this is how we practice kirtan every day. Come together, you sing the songs.
在崇拜神像的时候，大家可以一起来 kirtan， 来唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
So if you can't sing the songs like Guru Vastikam and Tosi Puja and Guru Arti, if you can't sing these songs which we sing every day, then that's not good.
如果你不能够唱诵这些歌曲，比如说突袭，比如说早上的这个，还有晚上的 RT， 这不太好。
So this is very important in family life.
这是家庭生活中非常重要的。
To get everyone connected to the deity.
让所有的人都和神像。
There's one big family there's one town, Kanpur, a city in India called Kanpur, and there's a family there, they're Hindu family, and they're very rich business family, and they have the deity, they worship the deity of Radha and Krishna.
在 Kanpur 有一个家庭，他们很富有，他们在家里崇拜着 Radha 和 Krishna.
So the family all live together, they have a very big house, and they all live different. So everybody in the family, they must come to see the deity every day.
他们这个家庭成员，都住在一起，他们每一天，所有的成员每一天都必须见神像。
And if they don't come, then there's a fine.
If they don't come,
they have to pay a fine.
Oh, 如果他们不来的话，他们就得付一个付钱。
要罚款。
哦，要罚款。
They have to. The pujari will say, "You did not come yesterday. You have to pay the fine."
This 家庭的祭司普加瑞就会在那里守着发现，如果你有谁不来的话，就得罚款。
那个崇拜神像的人说，你昨天没有来，你是要给我你的罚款。
对，崇拜神像的人说，昨天没有来，你得给我罚款。
And so you're a small family, but you should do kirtan every day.
你们的这个家庭不算大，是一个小的家庭，因此应该每一天唱诵 ，kirtan。
Very important。
非常重要。
Every day you must do kirtan。
每一天都得唱诵。
In Mayapur, nobody will complain you do kirtan。
而且你在 Mayapur， 如果你每天都唱诵的话，没有人会抱怨你、投诉你。
Anywhere else in the world, people will complain.
在世界上的其他地方，别人可能会抱怨。
But here in Mayapur, you can do a lot of kirtan.
但是在马来普，你可以做很多的 kirtan.
Okay. 还有问题吗？
好。Usa replied. Usa Manaji， 谢谢 Guru 的回答。我饿的时候总是最依附快供奉完的。快品尝普沙的，谢谢姑的指点。我一直都拖延时间服务神像，明天开始尽量准时干净的做服务。Thanks, Guru Maharaj replied. When I'm hungry, I just do offering the prasadam as soon as quickly as possible. I want to eat prasadam as quickly as possible. So thank you, Guru Maharaj.I often delay to offering worship the deity and missing the time. From tomorrow, I try my best to be punctual and be neat when I worship the deities.
Very good. Thank you.
很好，谢谢你。Okay, that's all for today.
Okay.Sati, 我们今天结束可以吗？
好的，古代，我们没有问题了。
你没有问题啊 ？OK。OK， 我们感谢苏古里来给我们精彩的翻译，感谢萨提主持今天晚上的活动，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，问问题，祝福你们。生活快乐，传教顺利。今天
感谢姑姑精彩的讲课。
十二月，我们叫 Prabhupada 马拉松，我们应该多拍手。这个月，我们鼓励奉献者，如果有机会，你可以拍一些手，很好，给得到 Krishna 的认识。
好的。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda Ki.